What happens when you fuse a Ferris wheel and a water slide into one spectacular ride system? We are standing here at Aqua Park Reda here in Poland and next to the slide wheel.
Yeah, they call it the Aqua Spinner here, and it's really a nice innovation in water slide technology.
Yeah, and it looks like a Ferris wheel and a slide in one.
Yeah, a lot of things are going to happen. The entire structure is going to rotate. We're going to slide back and forth. It's going to be so much fun.
I want to know how it works, and I want to know how they upkeep this ride. So maybe you have to check the outside and I will check the slide itself.
Let's go. So Arthur, we are about to start the safety checks. What do we have to do today?
Okay, so we need to check the wheel pressure and the bearings. The lubricant is okay with this.
So we are about to check all the technical components outside of the slide wheel. We have to go through this door and climb some stairs. Let's go. So here on the first platform, we have to check if everything is clear, and we can check the rubber tires driving the big wheel. The way we do it is we release the tires from the steel structure. In that way, we can see if the tires are still fine. And then we bring them back onto this rough surface. And then we can check if the pressure with which the tires are pressed against the wheel is all right. The tires are being actuated by electric cylinders. We have four of them, two on this side of the wheel and two on the other side. So on this side, everything looks perfectly fine, so we can check the other side as well. What we can see really nicely here is that this is the last part of the slide that does not move. And immediately after, we have a part of the slide that is going to rotate. Now, this rotation is realized at this point. We have a large steel ring and the slide is actually going through, and the steel ring makes sure that the entire wheel can rotate. What you can also see very nicely from this spot is how the slide is connected to the steel structure. You can see at the interface between the slide and the steel that there are four rubber buffers, and these are installed because if the slide wheel is rotating, some parts of the structure will bend a little bit, so we need to give way, and the slide itself is going to deform more than the steel. So in order to compensate that, we have installed four of these rubber components to compensate for this. So now we're ready with the first side. We just have to repeat everything we did on the other side as well. Let's go. So Arthur, we now checked the tires on both sides and the bearings on both sides. Everything looks good. What's the next step?
The next step is that we test a moving slide.
Wow, this looks so mesmerizing.
Yeah, it looks amazing, right?
How does this slide work?
There's two important elements. First of all, we have to understand how a normal water slide works. And the second thing is a Ferris wheel. Mm-hmm. So in a normal water slide, people sit in a raft and they just slide from high to low due to gravity.
Like a regular normal slide?
Normal slide. That doesn't change here. People enter on the far side. Mm-hmm. and they slide towards the lowest point of the ride.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Then, because of the rotation of the wheel, the raft is being picked up and moved to a higher position. And at a certain height, the shape of the slide is such that it moves to the next section.
So this ride has a few sections in it?
Yes, there are several sections. It repeats a couple of times. And at the end, for the final lift, the raft is raised to the same height as where we started. And then it leaves the rotating part and it just slides down all the way to the exit.
I do understand that, but how is it possible that the rafts are lifted by rotation?
Ah, the working principle behind it, it's very beautiful and it's based on the Archimedic spiral. The Archimedic spiral is named after the Greek Archimedes, but it was probably already invented in ancient Egypt. It consists of an inclined, screw-shaped spiral. The lower part is placed in water, and by rotating the spiral, water is transported up. And the Egyptians used systems like this to irrigate their fields with water from the Nile.
As you can see, I put on my helmet and special socks. But before we can enter the slide, we have to check all the sensors here at the station. This is actually the place where the rafts are entering the station. You can sit right here in this raft on this conveyor belt. This conveyor belt will go to another conveyor belt, and that's the dispatch conveyor belt. So at the right exact moment, that belt will automatically put you into the slide. That's why all the sensors are here, and we have checked them. They are okay. It's time to go into the slide. Because of the design of the slide, we have to operate it manually to walk through the slide. That's why we have the control right over here. So you can actually turn the slide at the right moment so we can walk through this maze of slide. Let's go inside. I'm feeling so dizzy at this moment, but we have checked the slide, everything is correct, and this is the exit of the, well, moving part of the slide. And here the rafts will enter the normal slide, so that's why you can see those pumps over here to give extra water for this section of the slide. Everything is checked, so this is actually a very special thing to see. So everything is checked, so we can start up the slide by pushing first this button. And then here we go, 3, 2, 1. My final question. In case of an emergency or technical failure, what will happen?
There's a couple of things. First of all, the ride operators can control the spinning of the wheel manually. Mm-hmm. So should the ride program, for whatever reason, not rotate the wheel as desired, they can do this manually. They overrule the ride control system and they rotate the wheel to a desired position. Then, in case of power failure, they have an emergency power supply over here. They can start it up and use the electricity generated from there to rotate the wheel again. Finally, should nothing like this ever happen before, in case the wheel is really stuck, at all the lowest points there are escape hatches and they can be opened and the fire department can evacuate the rider safely from there.
Actually, the park told us in all those years they operate this slide, they never have used those hatches, so it's actually very safe.
Yes. Danny, we had such an amazing day here at Aquapark Redda, here at the Aquaspinner.
It's such a good ride. I mean, when you're on the ride, you don't know when it's time to drop. So the slide is everywhere, and the beautiful colors and the splash. Yeah, wow, yeah, it's a blast. It's a great ride.
Yeah, it's amazing to see. It's amazing to ride it.
Indeed.
And for me, I think also a very interesting part is that the working principle is all based on this Archimedic spiral.
Indeed, and I want to thank Aquapark Reda for the amazing hospitality. Visit this amazing park here in Poland. And if you like this channel, thumbs up, subscribe to Theme Park Science, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye.